सेशन 12 ऑफ मॉड्यूल 1 ऑफ मैनेजरियल कम्युनिकेशन ऑफ सेकेंड सेमेस्टर बीबीए ऑफ मैंगलोर यूनिवर्सिटी। सेशन 12 और द लास्ट सेशन ऑफ मॉड्यूल 1 ऑफ बिजनेस कम्युनिकेशन। रिविजन, रिकैप ऑफ प्रीवियस सेशंस and important questions. In this session, in the first session, we have seen the syllabus of managerial communication. There are four units in this subject. First is business communication, second is managerial communication, third is management reports, which also includes business letters, and the fourth is commercial letters, where inquiries, reply to the inquiry, placing of order, execution of orders, then settlement of disputes or complaints, complaints and their adjustments, sales letters and circular letters are to be studied. Now, recap of previous sessions. In module 1, we have studied about meaning and definition of communication. To communicate is to exchange information from one person to another person. Importance of communication. Due to globalization and fast expanding of the business, there is a need for the right information to pass from one person to another and to take a right decision. The objectives of communication, important objectives of communication, like to pass the information, orders, advice, suggestions, persuasion, education, motivation. The process of communication or the steps followed in the communication process, where the sender sends the message. The message is encoded through a channel, which is the medium, like telephone or email. Then the message is decoded and received by the receiver, and he gives response, that is the feedback, to the sender, so that the entire communication process is successful. Next, we have studied about the types of communication. There are horizontal, where people of same position, people of different departments, managers of different departments communicate with each other. Vertical communication, which may have an upward and downward communication. Downward from the top to the lower level, and upward from lower level to middle to the top level. So orders and instructions may follow a downward communication, and suggestions or seeking redressal for the grievances may be upward communication. Next is grapevine, which is an informal communication. And also we have studied about consensus, where people or experts of different fields join together or discuss a matter, share opinions and arrive at a particular decision which is consented by all. Next is simple rules of effective communication, or the principles of effective communication, or the 7 C's. Conciseness, concreteness. So the 7 C's. Next is barriers to communication, which are the obstacles or the shortcomings, which are hurdles in the process of communication. So the information from the sender doesn't reach the receiver in a proper sense, or the message is distorted and it is misunderstood. So there are physical barriers, environmental barriers, and mechanical or instrumental barriers. Now we shall see the questions, important questions from the examination point of view, which are connected to this module 1. 4-mark questions under section A, which may be related to the different types of communication. Just you have to mention about the different types: horizontal, vertical, upward, downward, then grapevine, consensus. What do you mean by horizontal and vertical communication? What is upward and downward communication? You can give the meaning and with examples. What do you mean by formal and informal communication? Formal, which is systematically in a proper way performed. Informal is just like a grapevine. Other than the formal activities of the organization, for the friendliness, for improving the morale, informal communication is required. What are the features of grapevine? Then write a note on consensus. Next is section B, which has 8-mark questions. The differences between formal and informal communication, importance of effective communication in business, significance of grapevine, types of informal communication, process of communication chart, that is the steps followed, with you have to explain with the chart, drawing a chart. What are the rules or principles or C's of effective communication? 16-mark questions under section C. Define business communication and explain the objectives of business communication. A definition to be given. What do you mean by business communication? Meaning, and explain the barriers to business communication. What do you mean by upward communication? Explain the importance and methods of upward communication. What do you mean by downward communication? Explain the importance and methods of downward communication. Explain the different types of business communication. So here ends module 1. Thank you.